evening and good night to some of you. This is a very special broadcast, and of course, we must pray. And prayer we must, this very evening and always going forward. And I will pray in the language of heaven, because Chukwuka Abiyama is in control of all that we have been doing and will continue to do until Biafra is restored and all the suffering indigenous populations in the damnable Zoological Republic are set free. Chineke na nke pụrụ ihe niile Chukwuka Abiyama banyere ifewe na aja nso ya mgbe niile. Onye ọbụla naanị ya na-achị. Eli Gwano wana wake be honanya gine brega mragi no miko gebe ndege neze bede ngozi. Ani we ne to yi. Agwa ne gatma to joni ne kendi ro. Iwe nya nye ndo la kedi nwe ro no bochin keta. Ani we na se ne jam mani no to ni ne dra han sori. O nyo bona nya ki kini no no badra kaya. Ani we na pokuri. Na se gina nkoma mani ge kelegi nkojo mani kelegi. Ani we na jagema. We ne to you when I saw proge. Nisi umugiri ne bundi kundi we zo kumba poro ha. Kaha we chekwa alanso gabi biafro nyo mna chine kene. Ini kura nye mkwa. No meka take kandi yuno we wala alanso biafro nyo mna chine kene nke bini yuko. Abwa ne gato mato joni ne kendi yuno. Mande na abwa mbo bebe ni ne di chicho nyo mna chine kene. Ni hene bunke ni de tuwa no poti nketa. Ani we ne to you. We na si wanyo wanyi na chine kene nke prumi hene yine. Onyo bo nani ana zopota. Onye ọbụ naanị ya bụ okwu ya niile bụ ihe na amen. Anyị wee na-asị ezi ebube dị ngọzi na ụtụtụ na ịja mma na nsọpụrụ site n'ebighị ebi ma ruo n'ebighị ebi. Ise, ise, ise.
Welcome, my amazing viewers. Thank you so much for joining me on my program once again. I appreciate you wherever you are connecting from. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please kindly subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell so that you'll be notified each time I upload a video. You will be among the first to receive it. Thank you so much and remain blessed. Each time you watch my video, please kindly share the video to your family and friends. Share the video in all your WhatsApp group. Share it in any platform where you belong. Let the people hear what is happening in the country called Nigeria. We are setting the record straight. I am not trying to be politically correct here. I say it the way it is, raw. Bringing the information to your doorstep. It doesn't matter who is concerned. But I'm focusing on the issue of Biafra, the issue of the Oduduwa people and that of the Middle Belt. I am trying my possible best to see that we don't allow the conventional media to change the narrative. You can equally do the same. I am not on this alone. There are so many other people who are speaking on various platforms, setting the record straight and making sure that the conventional media do not change the narrative of what is happening in the country of Nigeria. We will always say it the way it is, without blinking an eye. We will set the record straight and make sure the world know the real information on what is going on in the country of Nigeria. Go to the comment section after watching. Put your own contribution in the comment section. You can criticize it if you so desire, but do it constructively so that we can learn from each other. That is why I'm here. Today, let us go into a video talking about the issue in the southeastern part of Nigeria. We will not stop talking. I personally will not stop talking. I will continue to speak about the situation of the southeastern part of Nigeria, Biafra land, until Biafra comes. And even after Biafra comes, we will continue to speak and set the record straight because a lot of damages have been done in the brain of the people in Biafra land and the Biafra itself. So many damage have been done. The contraption called Nigeria have destroyed the people so much that people have lost conscience. People do not longer know what is called humanity. People don't care about each other. People are now selfish and self-centered in all their attitude and what they are doing. And we cannot allow that to continue. The southeastern part of Nigeria, as I'm speaking to you now, is on fire. They are killing people on daily basis, abducting people for committing no crime. These people they are killing and abducting, they are not terrorists. They have not killed anybody. They have not kidnapped anybody to ask for ransom, only simply because they are asking for self-determination. And by the way, self-determination is not a crime. Self-determination is supported by international law, supported by African chartered law, and supported by Nigerian law itself. Ask me, why is it that Nigeria is coming hard on those who are asking for self-determination? Today, we all know that Sunday Igbowo is being held captive in Benin Republic. In Benin Republic, for committing no offense. He has not committed any offense. He entered Benin Republic legally. He has not committed any offense. Even the case he has in Nigeria, he has won the case and 20 billion was awarded to him. And yet, the Benin Republic has still held him, our brother Sunday Igbowo, captivity. They are holding him captivity. They have succeeded in buying everyone, including his own lawyers. They can't even come out and tell us the crime that we have committed and made it to hold you up to now. The political set in the southwestern part of Nigeria have been compromised, and they are part of the people making sure that Igbo is not released. We are talking about the case of Igbo. Our screen Mazin Nnamdi Kanu was kidnapped all the way from Kenya. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu traveled to Kenya with his British passport. He is a British citizen and a Biafran, not a Nigerian. He traveled to Kenya with his British passport. Legally, he was stamped in. He didn't enter illegal. And they went in Kenya and kidnapped him. Kenya government and Nigerian government connived together. They kidnapped Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, tortured him for good 8 days. They tortured Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, you heard me right, for good 8 days. Before finally, he was renditioned to Nigeria. On renditioning him to Nigeria, damning all consequences, knowing that this is against international law, Nigeria and Kenya committed that crime without minding, because they know that the world is in the game with them. United States is seeing what is happening. UK is seeing what is happening. They are not saying anything. They are not addressing the issue. Instead, they are busy making strong their bilateral relationship with Nigeria, a country that have committed such a serious crime of kidnapping a citizen of Britain and renditioning him to Nigeria. Still yet, instead of Britain standing strong and giving sanctions to Nigeria, they are making strong the relationship, bilateral relationship with Nigeria. The same thing with the US, trying to strengthen their bilateral relationship. The same thing with other European countries. They are all looking on what they are going to get in Nigeria, because the fraud that is happening in Nigeria benefits each and every one of them. Every European country can think of all these world powers. They are benefiting from the fraud that is happening in the country called Nigeria. That is why when you see them calling Nigeria corrupt, they are much, much corrupt than Nigeria. All these international communities you see, all these people you call world powers, you see them coming out to call Nigeria fantastically corrupt. They are the people who are more fantastically corrupt than any other person in the world. Every money that is gotten from corruption from Nigeria is being stored in either US or UK. The money they stole from their people, the money that is making the people impoverished, is being stored, reserved in UK and US. They know it very well. That the kind of amount we are mentioning, the kind of amount you will hear, individuals cannot earn that amount. People who are public servants cannot earn such amount. Yet, they open an account for them, they take this money and allow the poor people in the country called Nigeria to suffer. You see how they are playing the games. That is why you don't have to wait for them to fight for your freedom. You don't have to wait for them to come and fight or release Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, because they will never. Because Mazin Nnamdi Kanu stand against everything this colonialist represents. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu stand against everything the slave master represents. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu stand against it. That is why they are not speaking. That is why you don't hear their voice. That you don't hear the opera. After Mazin Nnamdi Kanu was kidnapped and sent to Nigeria, today Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is in captivity in Nigeria, in the DSS. Not even in the detention center, in DSS. He's been detained. He is still facing torture. Torture that you and I know that is against international law. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is still facing torture. Against all odds. Even when they are scared of trying his case in their own court, knowing full well that they don't have any case against Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, their own judge have ordered them to treat Mazin Nnamdi Kanu with respect, to give him all his rights, because he is innocent until proven otherwise. But what did they do? They continued to torture Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. The torture intensified. They included hunger strike. They begin to leave Mazin Nnamdi Kanu in hunger. They begin to deny him food. That is what is happening as I speak to you. And the denial of food started since these people begin to visit him, the people, so-called political elite, so-called Igbo elders. Just as in the case of Son Igbo, when you begin to see the people from the southwest trooping to the Republic to talk about the issue of Son Igbo, you thought they were going to release him. They only went there to cement the arrest of Son Igbo. This is the same thing they are doing to Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. When you see them going to see Mazin Nnamdi Kanu in DSS, you think they are going there to discuss the issue of Biafra or the freedom of the people. No. They are going there to intensify the suffering of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, to go and torment him more, to go and torture him more. That is what they are going to do there. To go and torture him more and persuade him to drop the struggle for Biafra, to stop fighting for the ordinary people. And Mazin Nnamdi Kanu said no, over his dead body. He has said it is either Biafra or death. Is either freedom or death. And he is standing on it 101%, and they know it very well. That is why they have intensified in the torture of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. to the extent that they're now denying him food. You see the reason why I do not believe in their so-called political solution. It is since they started this issue of political solution that the trouble of Martin Nandekani increased. Initially, we are hearing that Martin Nandekani is okay, he's on high spirit. But as soon as they started talking about the issue of political solution, the story changed. You no longer hear about Martin Nandekani being okay. What we are hearing on a daily basis is the way Martin Nandekani is facing dehumanization and torture. Even in the court, when it was being pronounced by a judge to treat him right, they increased it. Those who say they are going to go for political solution to this Martin Nandekani, have they been able to change his situation in DSS? Have they been able to make a case for Martin Nandekani to be treated right in DSS? Have they been able to make Martin Nandekani transfer to a correctional center? The easiest and simplest thing they can do with just a discussion, they couldn't do it. And they are telling you they are going to free Martin Nandekani. And you are believing them. And you, that you call yourself somebody who has something in his brain, you are believing them. You are living that thing that is working and you're believing them. You must be a fool. And you are fooling yourself, you're not fooling anybody. But I thank Chukwu Okeke Abiyama that there are still people who are standing just like Martin Nandekani is standing. There are still people who are following every single word Martin Nandekani has spoken. There are still people who are following Martin Nandekani toe-to-toe, working hand in hand to Martin Nandekani to see that things goes right. And I thank Chukwu Okeke Abiyama to give us those people. Somebody like Master Simon Ekpa. Recently, Simon Ekpa has come out to bring out a suggestion on what we are going to do. And I support that suggestion 101%. Civil disobedient. I have always said it. Civil disobedient is the only thing that is going to release our sooner Martin Nandekani. It's the only thing that is going to grant us freedom. Freedom for Martin Nandekani, which is the freedom of Biafra. As soon as Martin Nandekani is released, they know it, I know it, that is the freedom of Biafra. That is why we have to fight like never before. Speak like never before. Pray like never before. Civil disobedience remains the only solution. And if you have not started joining the civil disobedience, begin to join now. Thank God for our brother Simon Ekpa. He has brought a great and wonderful suggestion on how to make sure that these politicians do not know peace. This political elite do not know peace. This very politicians who are in the southeastern part of Nigeria, more especially, those who claim to be Ohanaeze Edinwo and rulers, they will no longer know peace. And that suggestion is that people in Biafra land will stop giving their revenue. Stop paying revenue to these state governments. Stop paying revenue to any federal government or state government organization in the southeastern region. Stop paying revenue to them. We have to stop giving them revenue. If you are from the Biafra land, begin to prepare yourself. In the next 1 week, we will stop giving them our revenue. If they come to your market where you are trading and request for the revenue, don't give it to them. It is because of this revenue you are giving them that is why they are still smiling. That is where they can be bold to begin to intimidate us and say they will not listen to what we are saying. It is high time we use that revenue for ourselves. Wherever you are doing your business or in the market, do not pay any revenue to anybody. And if you are one of those who have been employed to begin to collect revenue, if you are working in any company that is being employed to go and collect revenue for the federal government or the state government in the southeastern region, you better resign. It is better for you to resign and look for something else to do. Because if you don't resign and you continue to pursue that revenue, to collect revenue for people, you will pay with your own life. Yes, you will. Because we are fighting for our freedom and we are going to embark on civil disobedience, very strict conditions to make sure that our voice is being heard by the world and these very people who have refused to do something, they will do it by force. You saw what you have achieved with the sit at home. Even when the compliance was not 100%, the prior was 80%. You see what we were able to achieve. Everybody, they are all shouting and crying. That was why they begin to maneuver to bring out the issue of their political solution to deceive us. But we cannot be deceived. Now, since you and I have known that the political solution is a deceit, they are not willing to do anything, because since they talk about political solution, the problem of Martin Nandekani has increased. Now we are going to intensify the condition. No more revenue collection in the southeastern region, Biafra land as a whole. No more revenue collection. If you are in your business center, in your market, any place you don't agree, even the market leaders, stop paying those revenues. Stop paying revenue to the state. Keep it for yourself. And anybody that comes to force you to come and collect the revenue, deal with that person squarely. Every single Biafran has to enforce this. Let us reserve that money to build our own personal economy. Each time you see them talking about economy, they are talking about their own economy, economy of their own pocket and their own unborn children. It is high time we protect our children and our own unborn children by keeping that building an economy for our own people, for our own pockets. Every revenue that you are paying for the government, stop paying. Keep it to yourself. Keep it to yourself. And if you are part of those who are going to collect that revenue, if you're working in those companies who are collecting that revenue, who are stealing from their people, they steal billions. You have heard it. They collect billions from markets, marketplaces, from business places. They collect billions. But what do? They don't give you light. They don't give you road. Even representing you and just simple representation, they don't give to you. After stealing the whole money, collecting the ones you have, they will not represent you. They will never speak anything. Anything that you're bringing forward, they will never defend it, nor speak about it. That is the height of inhumanity of man against man. And we cannot tolerate it any longer. It is high time every Biafran will channel their energy where the energy is supposed to be channeled. No more revenue, no more revenue collection in Biafra land. Anybody who is working there, better look for another job, because it is going to come. People are going to come against you. It will be enforced. And you have to share this video. Share the video to every platform. Share the video to your family and friend. Share the video to everybody, even your WhatsApp group, so that people will hear and know what is going on. Only you and I can fight for ourselves. Nobody will fight for you. No single person, nobody is representing you. If you think you have somebody who is representing, nobody is representing you. Your senators are representing themselves and they are representing the Janjaweed. Your governors are representing themselves and representing the Janjaweed. Or Hanesendi is representing themselves and representing the Janjaweed. The political elites, all those people who you call rulers in Igbo land, all those people who you call names, who you praise, they are only serving their own personal interests. They don't care about you. They don't care. They don't even care about their own children. Because if they care about their children, they will know that anything they are doing today, that their children is going to pay in time to come. They know that their children is going to pay. But yet, they don't care. They don't care about anybody. They care about their own selfish interests. And their only mission is to make sure that we remain slave in this country called Nigeria. That is why they do not support the issue of Biafra. They don't support the issue of the Oduduwa people. They don't support the Middle Belt freedom. They don't support the freedom of indigenous people. If they mean well for you, they will be asking for self-determination, because 90% of the people in the southern part of Nigeria are asking for self-determination. The only people who are not talking about self-determination are the northerners. Not even the digital people, the Fulanis, they are the people not asking for self-determination, because already everything is in their hand. British is taking care of them, and they have decided to accept the slavery. Because right from the time of amalgamation, they said they are not ready. From independent time, they said they are not ready for independence. They want to be with the UK. And that is what they are still doing today. They still want to be with the UK. It doesn't matter whatever you do, because the UK knows that these people are the people who are willing to be slaves for them forever and ever. That is why they are supporting them. The United Kingdom will never support any other indigenous person except the Fulanis in that country called Nigeria. That is why their own citizen who travel with their own passport, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, a citizen of British citizen who travel with British passport to Kenya, he was kidnapped in Kenya. He never committed any crime in the UK. He never committed any crime. He wasn't wanted in the UK. They have not invited him anywhere in the UK for any crime. He traveled to Kenya with his visa, stamped him into Kenya. What did they do? Kenya went and kidnapped him. After kidnapping, they renditioned him to Nigeria. Damning all consequences, knowing that this is against international law. And what do you see? Instead of UK fighting for Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, fighting for their own citizen, they are busy strengthening their bilateral relationship with Nigeria. They are busy pushing arms and ammunition to Nigeria to protect themselves. They are busy talking about irrelevant things in Nigeria. What does that tell you? It tells you that they are part and parcel of the kingdom of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. Britain are part and parcel of it. United States deceptive. United States, who claim to be the home of justice, who claim to know everything about human rights. Today, somebody's right was abused in Kenya, in the open, the whole world, an international figure was abused in Kenya, kidnapped, and renditioned to Nigeria. Today, he's still in captivity in DSS. They are torturing him on a daily basis. U.S. is not saying anything about it. Instead, U.S. are busy sending their Secretary of State to go and begin to discuss with Nigeria on their bilateral relationship. Nobody is speaking up for him. The world is watching. The world is watching Nigeria killing an innocent man. The world is watching Nigeria killing an innocent man gradually, gradually, on a daily basis, and they are doing nothing. And you think it's okay. You think it's okay. I think it's not okay. It is very clear that nobody is going to fight for you if you don't fight for yourself. Freedom is not given in the platter of gold. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu has sacrificed everything sacrificable. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu gave up his throne, gave up his business, gave up his family, gave up his two parents. Today, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is an orphan because he's fighting for freedom. Because of you, because of me. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is not fighting for himself. He's not fighting for only the Igbos alone. He's not fighting for only the Biafrans alone. He's not fighting for only Southerners alone. He's not fighting for only the indigenous tribe alone. He's fighting for every single black man in this planet Earth, including every human being who loves justice. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is speaking up for justice. As soon as Mazen Nnamdi Kanu has become the symbol of justice all over the world, he has not been convicted anywhere or found guilty anywhere. He has not committed any crime anywhere in the part of the world. But today, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu was kidnapped unjustly in Kenya and renditioned to Nigeria. And nobody is talking about it. People are silent. Those of us who are protesting and speaking up on daily basis, when we speak, they will call us names. They come against us. When we begin to activate our civil disobedience to air our opinion, to demand for the unconditional release of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, some people will begin to talk down on it. Even people who claim to be standing for Mazen Nnamdi Kanu will be discouraging people to fight for him. If you don't fight for Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, Chukwuka Okeke will fight for him and he will release him unconditionally. It doesn't matter what you say, it doesn't matter what you do, it doesn't matter the angle you're coming from. Chukwuka Okeke will release Mazen Nnamdi Kanu when you don't expect it. He will. He will. He will. Just like God, just like the Bible said, that God said if you cannot be able to worship him, that he will raise stone to worship him. The same way, if you refuse to fight for Mazen Nnamdi Kanu freedom, Chukwuka Okeke will raise stone, will raise an enemy to free Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. And Mazen Nnamdi Kanu must tell you to be free. It doesn't matter what you say. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter the strategy you are bringing. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu must surely be free. But to those of us who are human, who still have conscience in them, we have to continue to embark on civil disobedience. We are raising the bar of the civil disobedience. Now, any revenue collection in the southeastern part of Nigeria has to be stopped. There will be no more revenue collection in Biafra land. Enough is enough. Stop giving your money to those who will kill you. Stop giving your money. They are using your money to kill you, using the money to plot evil against you. We are dealing with monsters who don't have conscience. You are here talking about politicians. Who are the politicians that are going to speak with you? Who are the politicians who are going to speak for you? Is it Hope Uzodinma is going to speak with you? Hope Uzodinma, even while we are crying, why the whole world is seeing the people they are killing in the southeastern part of Nigeria? Why Imo State is being ravaged by these very killer headers? Why the Boko Haram military are killing people in Imo State on a daily basis instead of Hope Uzodinma stopping them or looking for a way to stop them? Hope Uzodinma recently went to Asorok to demand for more military men to come into Biafra land to kill people. You have seen the burning of innocent people's home. You have seen the killing of innocent people. You have seen the kidnapping of innocent people in the southeastern region, mainly in Imo State, by a military invited by Hope Uzodinma. Even in the whole outcry, in the whole many talk of political solution, Hope Uzodinma did not stop in killing his own people. Hope Uzodinma instead have gone to Asorok to ask for more soldiers to come to the southeastern part of Nigeria and begin to kill Biafrans. I am not making it up. I want you to watch this video of what transpired in Asorok as Hope Uzodinma went to see the imposter in Asorok who claimed to be late Buhari. Watch this video.
The meeting went very well and we had a very convivial discussion, and I gave Mr. President my message, and Mr. President also in his usual manner addressed my issues to my satisfaction. Well, of course, you know, the prominent among other issues is just the the increasing insecurity in the Southeast. I know that despite the activities of the bandits and the non government, recall that the correctional facility in Owerri was broken, and over 1,804 inmates released. Since that time, they've been on rampage, committing all sorts of crimes, kidnapping, robbery, the other sorts of crimes in the state. And there is need for us to really clean up the state, because you know that this period of Christmas is so important to our people. And we want to ensure that those coming home to spend their Christmas will have a conducive atmosphere to enjoy their Christmas and then celebrate the season. Yes, we ask for support with the additional manpower. And also, I ask for some kind of funding to support the security situation in Imo State. And Mr. President graciously approved.
You have seen it for yourself. Are these the people that are going to represent you? Are these the people that are going to fight for you? Are these the people you are hoping on? Certainly not. That is why you have to wake up and stand up for your own self. As you are protecting for the reason of Martin and Ghani, you are protecting for your own freedom. You are asking for the... There are so many Biafrans that are in captivity as I speak. So many Biafrans have been held captive in different places. So many secret places. For committing no crime. Only because they identify as Biafrans with Biafran name. Only because they identify as Biafrans. They have not kidnapped anybody. They have not killed anybody. They have not seen... They are not seen with any arm. Simply because they identify as Biafrans. They have been locked up in jail. You saw the people who were released last time. After 15 good years, they were released without even sorry, no apology, no compensation whatsoever. This is where we find ourselves, and this is why you have to speak up. You don't know who is going to be tomorrow. You are keeping silent. You don't know who is going to be tomorrow. Those of them who are victim today, yesterday, they were survivors. Those who are going to be victim tomorrow, today, they are survivors. It is better you speak when you have the time. Time might come when you will not have time to speak. And they are coming for you. They are coming for me. It is not just... When we say protest for Martin and Ghani, it is not just Martin and Ghani. There are so many other people languishing in jail. And you are protesting for your own and for your own security. If you don't do it, they are definitely going to come for you. You see who is going to call for more military to come. They are not relenting. These politicians will never back down. They will never back down until we do something drastic. That is why I appreciate our brother Simon Ekpa, who has brought this suggestion that we have to prepare ourselves for this. In some weeks to come, we will stop payment of every revenue in Biafra land. And those who are working with the revenue collectors, you better begin to look for a new job now. You better begin to look for a new means to earn your money. Because if you continue to collect revenue from them, you are going to pay dearly. You are going to pay dearly. God help you. If you refuse this warning, we are giving you warning. In a space of a week or a week plus, it will be fully activated. And if you continue to embark on collection of revenue in the southern part of Nigeria, you are going to pay dearly. It is better you need to look for a new job. And those who are doing business in the southern part of Nigeria, all the marketplaces, all the market leaders, all the leaders of different places, you have to begin to work with your own people. This is the time to make our voice heard. The allocation they have been collecting, the revenue they have been collecting, they are doing nothing with it, except they are using it to fight against you. It is that same revenue they are using to buy fuel for the military that are killing you. It is that same revenue they are getting. That is what they are using to sponsor the Boko Haram that are coming to kill you in the name of military. How long shall you continue to remain there and watch yourself kill? Enough is enough. It is high time we wake up. And the best way and the best thing for us to do now is to continue to activate that very civil disobedience to the highest level. Any other thing you know you can do to make sure that these very politicians, this very political elite, these very so-called leaders and rulers will never have peace. they will not have a landing place. They will not have an upper hand anymore. Begin to do it. If you are praying, pray more. If you are broadcasting, broadcast more. If you are shouting, shout more. If you are fighting, fight more. Anything you are doing, if you are sitting at home, sit at home more. Sit at home more than ever. Increase more days if you can. On your own, nobody's enforcing it. This is the right thing to do. And this is the only way we can free our minds in the garden and free ourselves and bring Biafra to us, and our children will survive from this very killing and captivity. May Chukwuka be our guide and protect everyone that has watched this video from beginning to the end. May Chukwuka be our guide and protect and bless every hand that will share this video, every hand that will spread this news, every hand that share this video. Chukwuka be our will bless you and keep you. You will walk into Biafra alive. No man born of a woman can take away your life. May Chukwuka be our guide and protect every Biafran. May Chukwuka be our guide and protect every Oduduwa. May Chukwuka be our guide and protect every middle better. May Chukwuka be our guide and protect Sunday Igbo. Wherever Sunday Igbo is at this material hour, may Chukwuka be our guide and protect Sunday Igbo. Secure him, give him good health so that he can come out safely and continue in the struggle. May Chukwuka be our guide and protect our leader, Mazin Nadikano. May Chukwuka be our guide and protect Mazin Nadikano. Secure him. Give him wisdom. Give him more knowledge. Send doctors spiritually to continue to guide and protect him and secure him. Every poison that they have injected in him, Chukwuka be our guide will send doctors from above to take them out. May Chukwuka be our continue to give Mazin Nadikano revelation. Very soon he will join us and we will walk into Biafra alive, smiling greatly. No man born of a woman will stop the freedom of Asuna Mazin Nadikano. He will be free and he will join us very soon. Thank you so much for watching wherever you are watching from. They will kill us, we will kill them. At the end of the day, Biafra is here. Thank you and remember us. Bye bye. See you again on the next video. Thank you.